Today's song is Oft Gefragt by AnnenMayKantereit. Now, this band name may sound like a mouthful, but it's really just the three band members' last names strung together. They also have a YouTube channel, which got them popular about 3 years ago. I've linked the song in the description, so you can check out both the song and the channel if you want to. Oft Gefragt, which literally translates to often asked or often wondered, is one of my favorite recent songs, for several reasons, which I'll get into after translating it. You could call this another love song with a twist, just like, but in that entirely different from the first song on this format. So, let's go, translation first, analysis after.
Du hast mich angezogen, ausgezogen, großgezogen. Und wir sind umgezogen, ich hab dich angelogen. Ich nehme keine Drogen, und in der Schule war ich auch. You dressed, undressed, raised me, and we moved. I lied to you, I don't take drugs. And I also went to school. Du hast dich oft gefragt, was mich zerreißt. Ich wollte nicht, dass du es weißt. Du warst allein zu Haus, hast mich vermisst und dich gefragt, was du noch für mich bist.
You used to wonder what's torturing me. I didn't want you to know. You were home alone, missing me and wondering how much you mean to me anymore.
Zu Hause bist immer nur du. Zu Hause bist immer nur du.
Only you are always home.
Du hast mich abgeholt und hingebracht, bist mitten in der Nacht wegen mir aufgewacht. Ich habe in letzter Zeit so oft daran gedacht.
You picked me up and took me there, used to wake up in the middle of the night because of me. I've been remembering that a lot lately.
Wir waren in Prag, Paris und Wien, in der Bretagne und Berlin, aber nicht in Kopenhagen. Du hast dich oft gefragt, was mich zerreißt, und ich habe aufgehört, mich das zu fragen. Du warst allein zu Haus, hast mich vermisst, und dich gefragt, was du noch für mich bist.
We went to Prague, Paris and Vienna, to Brittany and Berlin, but never to Copenhagen. You used to wonder what was on my mind. I stopped wondering about that. You were home alone, missing me and wondering how much you mean to me anymore.
Zu Hause bist immer nur du. Zu Hause bist immer noch du.
Only you are always home. You're still home.
Ich hab keine Heimat. Ich hab nur dich. Du bist zu Hause für immer und mich.
Du bist zu Hause für immer und mich is repeated 5 times, and then the last 2 lines are just repeated once again. I don't have a home, I've only got you. You're home forever and for me.
Okay, so, some smaller linguistic stuff first. The first stanza starts off very interesting in a way that can't be translated but easily noticed, so I'm sure a lot of you already saw it.
All of the verbs used for the first 2 lines are prefixed versions of the verb ziehen. So, angezogen is the G-form of jemanden anziehen, which here means to dress somebody. The verb has other meanings, but we'll leave those out for this purpose. You could also make it reflexive, so sich anziehen, which then means to dress yourself, so to put on clothes. Ausgezogen, from jemanden ausziehen, is the antithetic word, so that means to undress somebody. And of course, you can also sich ausziehen, to undress yourself, or to take your clothes off.
Großgezogen comes from großziehen, which means to raise, so from childhood to adulthood, same implications as in English. And then finally, we have umgezogen, from umziehen, which here means to move, as in moving from one city to another, so changing the place you live. Interestingly, sich umziehen can also mean to change clothes, just like jemanden umziehen. So either you changing from one set of clothes into another, that's sich umziehen, or when you're changing the clothes of somebody else, that would be jemanden umziehen. There's no way in which it could mean that here, by the way, for the simple reason that we have a perfect here, and it says wir sind umgezogen, so it uses sein as an auxiliary here instead of haben, so that means it's definitely to move here, but you might find that interesting nonetheless, I thought. Another thing worth mentioning about the first stanza is that the last 2 lines, und in der Schule war ich auch, very nicely demonstrate the flexibility of German syntax. The sentence could also have been und ich war auch in der Schule, which wouldn't change its translation into English, because the syntax in English is usually much more rigid, but in German it serves to emphasize on whatever stands before the verb. Thereby, the implication becomes that the topic of whether or not the protagonist went to school like he was supposed to instead of skipping class or something must have been at least somewhat central to his relationship with the person he is talking to. The second stanza contains the verb zerreißen. So when something is zerreißen you, it means that it is causing you constant emotional pain. It literally means to rip or to tear apart. And while we are all very aware in times in which the room exists that this verb can be used in relation to emotions in English too, and also it wouldn't be, by the way, a bad translation, of course. I just felt that feeling tortured would be a slightly more fitting translation. But, you know, you could fight me on that. Also, this is the first time we encounter the titular oft gefragt, which may make a lot more sense to you in a connected sentence. Note that sich etwas fragen means to wonder something or to wonder about something. If I'm not mistaken, you sometimes even still hear the phrase I ask myself in more literal or lyrical works in English today, too. The third stanza, after the tease at the song's theme, starts with du hast mich abgeholt und hingebracht, which doesn't translate terribly well. But it's easy to explain. Hinbringen is, not exclusively, but in this context, is what parents do for their kids' afternoon activities. So, let's say if your child has soccer practice, you first hinbringen her and then later abholen her. Ich habe in letzter Zeit so oft daran gedacht literally means I've been thinking of that so often lately, but can also mean I've been pondering that a lot lately, or as you will see from my translation, I think most likely, I've been remembering that a lot lately. It kind of depends on the nuances of how you interpret it, but generally, an etwas denken, though it has a wide range, it connects to remembrance most of the time. What it never means is to think about something in the sense of trying to make sense of something, so to mull something over, to get at its meaning or something. That would be über etwas nachdenken. And now, let's get into the nitty-gritty. This comes in two parts. The first is looking at what the constant use of the perfect tense does to this song when you translate it. The second, and my favorite part about this one, is the wide range of detail to the phrases that make up the thematic through line. Now, I made some more extensive videos about the German past tenses that you are welcome to check out, but for now, let me summarize it like this. The perfect is a tense that is counted as a past tense in German, not a present tense like the present perfect is in English. Because of some of the nuances in how tense works in English, though, you can translate the two into each other on quite a lot of occasions. And this becomes especially tricky in spoken German because the perfect is the past tense that is used much more in spoken language, and oft gefragt happens to be written very much as if the protagonist was talking to somebody. Now, most of the lines are doubtlessly best translated using the past tense, just because of the clear context of childhood, but some are debatable. One example would be wir waren in Prag, Paris, etc. I translated that line as we went to, but there are arguments that would support it being we've been to. I personally think past tense fits better just because it falls in line with the rest of the song's reminiscence theme and because the protagonist probably no longer takes trips or travels with their assumed parent, but it's worth pointing out that you could argue about this. Another case is ich habe aufgehört, mich das zu fragen. It can either mean I stopped wondering about that at some point, or I've stopped wondering, so the latter implying a more recent stop. The German version doesn't offer a clear answer to this, so feel free to make up your own mind. This is just meant to make you more aware of quirks of German. And now, finally, clearly this song is a child talking to their parent. The singer has even commented that it is actually a song dedicated to his father, but it's also clear on an interpretational level. And what makes this song so powerful and tear-jerkingly beautiful is the different nuanced meanings you can find in these three lines. Zu Hause bist immer nur du, zu Hause bist immer noch du, and ich hab keine Heimat, ich hab nur dich, du bist zu Hause für immer und mich. The first line, zu Hause bist immer nur du, rawly literally translated would be at home are always only you. Now, that can mean you're always home alone because nobody else is in the house with the person, but the best translation is only you are always home because that one contains the second less obvious meaning. Only this person is home in the sense of what feels like home. Also interesting in this regard, by the way, is the fact that the protagonist specifically mentions that they moved at some point from one supposed home to another. So that could play a role in why the feeling of home is attached to the parent, as opposed to a place. Then we have zu Hause bist immer noch du. Only one word changes here. Nur to noch, which gives us immer noch, which means still or even still. So immer noch is has a slightly different meaning than noch in German. So now we have at home or always still you. Or in actual good English, you are still home. The double meaning, again, also works in English, so I don't think I need to explain it further. And then finally, I don't have a home, or if you want to translate it a lot more freely, you could also say, I don't have any roots, I only have you. Now, Heimat, die Heimat, as in the line, ich hab keine Heimat, usually means home when referring to an area, a place. That could be a country, a region, or a town. Usually it's not a single house, but it's definitely referring to a physical place. What it isn't is a person or an unattached, vague feeling of home. Meaning, in this line, the song establishes a clear contrast between a space that is home, which can be called Zuhause, just like, you know, anything you attach that feeling to, but this place can also be called Heimat. And the feeling of home, Zuhause, that they feel in connection to the parent that they are talking to. Which leads us to the final line. Du bist zu Hause für immer und mich. You are home, either literally, so you are at home, or metaphorically, you are my home. You are what makes me feel like home. Forever and for me. Again, either at home, there, for me, when I need you, or to me, you are home. And that's it for today. Check out my Patreon if you want to know how you can get the written version of this analysis, suggest future songs, and be listed like all of these lovely people you are seeing pop up on the screen right now. If you follow the link in the description, that's also on the screen right now, you can find out how you can do that. Also, if you like this song, make sure to check out more by AnnenMayKantereit. They make wonderful music, and most of their lyrics are as thoughtful and beautifully heavy as this song's. As for me, I've had enough talking for one day, so bis nächste Woche. Tschüss!